Hello, welcome to Physics with Amol sir. So this video is for class 9 and we will continue with our chapter motion. So in the previous video we talked about the distance time graph, that is XT graphs. Okay, I hope that concept was understood. Today we are going to talk about VT graph, that is velocity time graph. Okay, so let's begin. So today we will be seeing the VT graph, that is velocity time graph. For VT graph, we will be taking velocity on the y-axis and time as on the x-axis. Okay, so here is a case. So we have been given a table where the velocity and time relations are given. Time is in seconds, velocity is in meter per second. So let us say for the first second, in 1 second velocity is 5 meter per second. 2 seconds it is 10 meter per second, and 3 seconds the velocity becomes 15 meter per second. So you can see this will be an example of uniformly accelerated motion. Okay, because for the same time intervals, the same change of velocity is being observed. Okay, so let us plot the graph. So on the x-axis, we have the margins from 1, 2, 3, and on the y-axis, we have 5, 10, 15. So first point, time is 1, velocity is 5. So first point would come here. Second point is velocity is 10 for time 2. So this would be the second point. Okay, third point is velocity is 15 for time 3 seconds. Then if you see all the three points, you will be seeing that they are in a same line. So we get a straight line graph. So what do we understand from this? We understand that if the motion is a uniformly accelerated motion, the VT graph is going to be a straight line. Okay. So that is something to we have to remember. If the motion is not uniformly accelerated motion, for example, here you see, we have changed the parameters now. So in first second, velocity is 0. So the object is not moving. After 2 seconds, velocity is 5 meter per second. And after 3 seconds, it is 15 meter per second. You can see now this is not a uniformly accelerated motion. We are having non-uniform acceleration. Now let us plot the graph. So first point will be here. Okay, time is 1, velocity is 0. So this will be the first point. Then next point, velocity is 5 and time is 2 seconds. This is the second point. Third point, velocity is 15 and time is 3. This is where we see the third point. You can notice that these three points, now they are not in the same line. So the graph becomes like this. Okay, it is not a straight line graph, it is a curved graph. So we understand that the velocity time graph for non-uniformly accelerated motion is not a straight line, it is a curve. Okay. What if object is having same velocity continuously? That is, it is having a uniform motion. Okay, so if the velocity remains constant, that is 10 meters per second, 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second. Okay, how will the VT graph look like? So we will see for all the times the velocity is the same, that is 10 meter per second. In that case, the graph is going to be a straight line parallel to the time axis. Okay, so if you see a graph like this, this shows the motion is uniform motion. There is no acceleration. Acceleration is zero. Okay. So if the VT graph is a straight line, that means it is a uniformly accelerated motion, as you are seeing here. Okay. So if in the exam you are shown a VT graph and it is a straight line, you can specify that it is a uniformly accelerated motion. Fine. And then what can we understand from this particular graph? First thing, as in the previous case, you can find the slope of the graph. Correct? I am sure now you remember how to find slope. You need to specify two points. Let us call them as A and B. Okay. And then we construct a triangle in this case. Call this point as C. And then we find the slope. I am sure you remember the formula for slope also. It will be AC divided by BC, or the Y component divided by X component. Okay. The slope of VT graph will give us the acceleration. Okay, obviously now this will be for a uniformly accelerated motion. Okay, so if we
have a graph, a VT graph for uniformly accelerated motion. Slope of the graph will give us the value of acceleration. Remember this. Okay, so the slope of VT graph gives the value of acceleration. But there is one more thing that you can find out. Okay, you can see we have extended A on the x-axis, a perpendicular, and similarly a perpendicular on the x-axis from B. If you find the area of this, okay, and I think it is very easy to find the area, you can see it is a trapezium, okay. If we find the area of this shaded region, this will give us the distance that is traveled from 2 seconds to 4 seconds, okay. So, the area below the VT graph gives the value of distance covered, okay. This is the second thing to remember,
okay. So, I hope that the concept of VT graph is understood. Okay, now you should draw the diagrams for velocity time graph for uniform motion, velocity time graph for uniformly accelerated motion, and velocity time graph for non-uniformly accelerated motion. Okay, then you should understand that slope of the graph gives the value of acceleration. So, if you are seeing the graph for two different objects, whichever is having more slope will have more acceleration. Okay, so these are some things that we have to remember. In the next class, we are going to see one important proof, the proof for the kinematic equations. But for you to understand that proof, the knowledge of graph is very, very important. Okay, so make sure that you understand XT graph and VT graph properly. Okay, thank you.